Now I'll show you a quick overview of the equipment that needs to be installed for the Sonnen battery system. So within this fuse board, we have a circuit for the Sonnen battery, a circuit for the Sonnen meter, and the Sonnen meter itself. The meter calculates when the battery needs to charge and when the battery needs to discharge. Connected to this meter are two current transformers, or CT clamps. One is on the solar PV circuit to monitor how much the solar is producing. The other is on the mains to monitor how much the house is consuming. The next piece of equipment is a rotary isolator. This will mean that the battery can be totally isolated from the household system if there was ever a fault or if any maintenance needed to be carried out. Lastly, we have the Sonnen battery itself. This is the largest battery that can be installed on a domestic supply. Within this cabinet, there are six 2.5 kilowatt battery modules, totaling 15 kilowatts of battery storage. The Sonnen is designed to store surplus solar power when it's not needed during the day, and then discharge that power when it is needed, either throughout the day or on an evening. This means that less power needs to be provided from the grid, and so cutting your electricity bills down. As well as a battery like this being designed to store solar PV power, it can also charge up during the night when a cheap electricity tariff may be in place. These are becoming more and more common with the rise of electric vehicles. In that case, this can be programmed to charge up during the night from the hours of, say, midnight to 4 in the morning, meaning that in the morning when you wake up, you've got a fully charged battery on 4 pence per unit electricity. Economy 7 feature is usually used during the winter months when solar PV generation is less, but the battery still can be used to reduce your energy bills. As the Sonnen battery is connected to the internet, this allows us to monitor what is happening with the solar, the battery, and how much the house is actually consuming. It also shows us if the battery is charging or discharging. Here we can see that the solar production is around 2,200 watts. The consumption in the house is around 200 watts, and the battery is currently charging at around 2,000 watts. The state of charge is at 50%. As charge rates are constantly changing, sometimes small amounts of power are fed back to the grid. As we can see from the figures in each one of these tiles, the figures are changing every couple of seconds. This portal is only available on the home network. Next, I'll show you the portal that's available wherever you are in the world. This is the online portal. You can see it's got the four tile arrangement slightly like the previous one. However, if we click on here, it will show us a snapshot of what's been happening in the system. So we can see the solar is producing 2.7 kilowatt, the house is consuming 0.2 of a kilowatt, and the battery is charging with 2.4 kilowatts. It's also 46% charged. Here we can see everything that's been happening, not only in the battery, but it's been happening on the solar, in the house, and if the battery has been charging or discharging. There's a lot of information here, and each part can be removed to just reveal the information that's required. By clicking each one of these indicators at the bottom, it will remove it from the chart and show us just the information that we want. So here we can see an overview of how the solar has been performing at this property. If we wanted to overlay that with how often it's been charging and discharging, and how much consumption there was, we can add each individual part one at a time. This not only allows us to track the performance, but helps us identify if there's ever a problem with the battery. If we scroll down, it reveals these two pie charts. The first pie chart shows how much of the production has been fed back to the grid and how much has been either directly used by the house or sent into the battery. The second pie chart shows the total amount that the house has consumed, how much of that has been bought in, and how much of that has been either sent straight from the solar or via the battery.